intended to collect myself all night. Really wouldn't do that. Let's sing the song, then call me after. I was tearing up over there crying. It's a beautiful song. It really touched me. And I asked Sister Renee, were they going to sing that song? It's such a beautiful song, Pastor. And so I really enjoyed it. Let us pray. Father, we give you thanks today, Lord. For Father, your word says in all things, give thanks. Father, we just thank you for one more day, for allowing us to come into your holy presence, Father, to give you glory and to give you honor, and to lift up your holy name, Father. And Father, as we celebrate, Lord, your life, and all you've done for us, Father on Calvary, we just come today, Lord, just to say thank you, Lord. Just to bless your precious holy name, Father. For Father, you're truly worthy to be praised. So we thank you, Lord. We glorify in knowing, Father, that you are God. And beside you, there is no other. We pray and amen. I was supposed to get back to Pastor, amen, about the title, amen. But the title is simply this: For God So Loved the World. Amen. For John 3:16 says, For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. As we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus, I would like to talk today about God's unfailing love for us. Romans 5:8 reads, But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. John 15:13 reads, Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. What a wonderful and loving God we serve. And to really understand that love that our Savior has for us, we must understand and know him in his suffering. Isaiah 53:5 reads, But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. We must also know him in his death. John 19:30 reads, When he had received the drink, Jesus said, It is finished. With that, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. But furthermore, Pastor, we must also know him in his resurrection. Luke 24:5 reads, And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, Why seek ye the living amongst the dead? He has risen. Hallelujah. And finally, we must know him in his power. If you can turn with me to Matthew 28, 18, verse 18 to 20, let us read this together. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. God loved us so much that he sent his son to die for us. So as we celebrate this Christmas, we remember that God's unfailing love was shown on Calvary. That he loves us so much that the Bible teaches us that while we were yet sinners, while we yet did not deserve it, Christ died for us. How wonderful was that to know that God loved us so much that although we deserved a sinner's death, he died for us. He loved us so much. The Bible says, greater love has no man that he would lay his life down for his friend. So as we celebrate this time of the year, and we receive our presents and we give out presents, we must remember the most important gift that we have received, salvation. Although we spend our money in the store, and we at this time we look in our pockets, we have lit left from all the money we spent on these expensive presents, we remember that the gift of salvation is free. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him, whoever, the gift of salvation is free for everyone. For anyone. So at this time of the year, let us ponder on that. Let us ponder on the gift of God, the love that he showed on Calvary for us, for our children. The love he has for us all. Pastor said it, that he is interceding for us right now through that love. That love that woke us up this morning. That love that let us see another day. That love that brought us here this morning. That love that kept us in our right minds this morning. That love that sustains us. That love that he showed, that delivered us from a sick and dying world. That love that we should share, not with just one another, but with the world. For the Bible says that we should go out and let that love shine, so that people may know Christ. I read something interesting, and I want to share it with you. And it touched me, Pastor, but it also gave me an understanding of what I needed to be doing. This was in a magazine called The Christian Daily. And it said the number one cause of atheism and convergence to other religions is Christians, or so-called Christians. Those who proclaim God with their mouths and deny him with their lifestyles. See, the world is looking at us. They're watching how we act. They're watching how we speak. They watch our talk. We must emulate Christ. For God says, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto you. So in our everyday walk and in our lives, we must lift up Christ. People must see Christ in us in order for them to want to be a part of what God is doing. We must lift him up at our jobs. Wherever we go, we must lift up Christ. And let people know about that love, that unfailing and undying love that Christ has for us. It's not enough to just to talk about it. See, me and my brother, we go back and forth. We talk about different things. And I'm going to say this, not going to be before you long, but I'm going to share this with you. I've been involved in a lot of different religions, if you will, Pastor. And the Bible says religion is a form of godliness. And I realized something. I realized that there was a difference between religion and a relationship. I'll say it again. There's a difference between a religion and a relationship. I realized that when I was with the Muslims, I just wanted to be part of that religion. When I was with the Jehovah's Witness, I wanted to be a part of that religion. But when I came to know there is a Savior, then I realized what having a relationship really was. The more I get to know him, I realize what having a relationship is. See, I had a relationship with that religion, but not with the risen Savior. Not with the risen Savior. I got caught up in that religion. But when I realized who Jesus is and what he did for me, Pastor, and what he continues to do for me on a daily basis, knowing that he is the one who wakes me up. He is the one who sustains me. He is the one who keeps me. When I realized who he was, then I realized the difference between religion and having a relationship with the risen Savior. What a wonderful thing to know the risen Savior. What a wonderful thing to know Jesus. What a wonderful thing to know that he died for us. That he loves us so much. And I'm going to tell you something, and then I'm going to close. I've been involved in so many different religions. And I realized the impersonal ability about the religions. As I studied this, the Islamic religion, I realized that their God, if you will, was not personal. That he was not touched by your infirmities. Mm-hmm. Actually, it read that if you were sick, it was his will. So I realized that this was a religion, and that's all it was. That it wasn't about a relationship. The more I read it, the more I understood that all arrows pointed to Jesus. If you studied it, you would understand what I mean. That all avenues, all arrows pointed to Jesus. They make a claim, and if someone asked me, they said, well, is the God of Islam and the God of Christianity the same God? And I said, absolutely not. And they said, well, why not? In the Quran, it says that he's the Messiah. I said, but it's one most important fact that they missed. And that fact was the resurrection, the crucifixion and the resurrection. See, they denied the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. And if you deny the crucifixion, you deny the resurrection. If you deny the resurrection, then you deny the redemption. Mm-hmm. Amen? For the Bible says, I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. So when they denied the crucifixion, I said, oh no, that's not the same God. That is the basis of the New Testament, amen? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That is the basis, the whole basis of the New Testament. So when they denied, and you got to be careful, because they'll trick you into believing it's the same thing. They'll add a few things that sound similar. And I realize that they'll add a few things that make it seem similar. But when you get into it and really understand it, you realize, wait a minute, this is a false, it's fake. So in closing, I just want to say, thank God for Jesus. Thank God that we know the risen Savior. Thank God that we have a wonderful man of God, our pastor, a wonderful shepherd who rightly divides the word of truth, who knows the truth, and who has a personal relationship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. God bless you.